Here at home, the Philippine government eyes filing an arbitration case against Chinese manufacturer CRRC Dalian over the trains it supplied to the Philippines. Andrea Taguines tells us why.
Transportation Department is eyeing to file an arbitration case against Chinese manufacturer CRRC Dalian over the trains it supplied to the Philippine government for the MRT-3 nearly a decade ago due to non-compliance with technical specifications. The issue with the Dalian trains, which were procured in 2014 and delivered in 2017, again made headlines recently after Senator Raffy Tulfo said he plans to reopen the Senate investigation into the China-made trains' supposed incompatibility with the MRT-3 system. On Friday, Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista confirmed that the 3.8 billion peso trains turned out to be overweight, which is why they were never fully deployed.
Meron tayong konting issue dyan, no? Kasi yung na-deliver sa atin ay parang hindi in conformity with the agreed terms, no? mas mabigat siya. The reason why we don't like to operate those trains at this time, no? Kasi posibleng maging mas mataas yung maintenance cost, no? Yung maintaining also the rail line, no? Might be affected also. It can result to higher operating costs also.
The agency is still looking into possible penalties against Dalian.
Magkakaroon niya ng what? Ng liquidated damages yan, no? Kasi hindi nila na-meet yung requirements natin, no? But of course, subject to agreement that we should be fair and reasonable in terms of what should be collected from Dalian. No? Possibly magkaroon ng arbitration, yan, no? In fact, parang makikita ko na doon papunta yung problem natin with Dalian, right?
Bautista said the arbitration case may be filed before a Singapore court ahead of the planned privatization of the MRT-3 in the second or third quarter of next year. But a train expert doubts the Philippines would win.
Kung defective, right from the very beginning, they should have rejected it. The fact is they have accepted it. They have not returned it over 7 years under their control. Kahit na itsampan mo sa International Chamber of Commerce arbitration yan, talong Pilipinas yan.
For Santiago, the weight of the trains is not that big of a problem and the DOTR should just deploy the trains to benefit the riding public.
They're really concerned with public welfare. For the commuters, they should immediately build the 48 Dalian rail cars. Mm-hmm. That is a 66% increase in capacity of MRT-3. Will the system be harmed by the extra four tons, the excess? No, because the truck have a safety margin. The only compensation or negative effect, yung lifespan or the steel rails will need replacement sooner than, let's say, 10 years, baka maging 8 years.
Santiago said since the MRT-3 is set to be run by a private concessionaire next year, the DOTR can just turn over the maintenance requirements to whoever bags the deal. Bautista said this is another option they are considering.
We have to involve the private sector. Yung unsolicited proposal, meron silang provision dun sa how to operate Dalian train. No?
Despite the way.
May mga solutions kasi sila na naiisip.
In the meantime, Bautista said CRRC Dalian continues to work on making the trains more suitable.
Tinitiran kung paano babawasan yung weight. Siguro, if we will be satisfied, no, we can agree with them to operate the Dalian train. So far naman ngayon, hindi naman nagkukulang pa yung train requirements ng MRT-3.
The DOTR has also expressed willingness to face the Senate for an inquiry into the Dalian trains. Andrea Taguines, ABS-CBN News.